Mais c'est vous seulement qui le savez.
Progetto d'arte. E io sono molto caro.
A most interesting idea. What is your name?
Michelangelo di Caravaggio.
Michelangelo? Michelangelo.
Oggetto d'arte. E io sono molto caro.
Taking this found footage's fragments to reflect the typically classical attitude toward cinematographic representation. Some critics argue that the film represents the absence of the viewer. But I argue, on the basis of an analysis of point of view, that the viewer is both where and not where the protagonists are, in the reflections of the space where the footage is made. And I come to the paradoxical conclusion that above the Foucault ideas, there is even another layer, the Rabbonic cameraman that is seen while filming this scene. The space in which he films it similar to the 17th century salons of the castle, as if a 17th century camera obscura has made this all. First, then, in Foucault theory the viewer's absence is signified. But here, we can see the factual obvious place for the viewer, the reflections in the middle of the monitor, occupied by Rabbonic filmmaker. Foucault's reading is based on the hypothesis of self-reflexivity in its double meaning of visual mirroring and discursive thinking. Mirroring and discursive thinking. He takes the first as a metaphor for the second, staying, himself, on the side of discursive reflection on the work's self-mirroring. I contend that it may be the most powerful aspect of the idea itself, that these two meanings tend to be conflated in self-reflection. But here we clearly to see the double, triple presence of the viewer. The Rabbonic filmmaker is not only looking out right into the viewer's eyes, but also ostentatiously posing for him or her. And when we realize that it is the work, not us, that makes this double subject opposed to the footage visible. So actually, there is a place for the viewer, even to double it immediately. It is this basic extra that proposes self-reflection to the viewer. An extra mirrored image of another subject takes the viewer's place here. Yet the distance between different layers on the monitor and the angle of vision represented muddles the line of vision between viewer and represented players. It is exciting for viewers to feel that the monitor intermediates between the viewer and the players. We become less certain how to split the original filmmaker or the Rabbonic filmmaker that are looking at us. Just as every film contains an implicit, I see, so according to Kant every mental representation contains an implicit, I think, and according to speech act theory every speech act can be accompanied by an explicit performative, for example, I say. But just as in thought, the I of the I think, need not be that of the self, in fantasy, for example, and in speech acts, the I of the I say, need not be that of the speaker or writer, in ghost writing, for example, so in these fragments, the eye of the IC is not that of the original filmmaker but of the Rabbonic filmmaker that filmed these fragments.